सुप्रभातम, सुस्वागत। भक्ति योग, द पाथ ऑफ इमोशंस, इफ यू यूज इंटेलेक्ट इन द पाथ ऑफ ज्ञान योग, यूज द पाथ ऑफ विल पावर, विल पावर वी यूज इन राजयोग, इन कर्म योग वी कन्वर्ट एवरी एक्शन इनटू ए योग, in bhakti yoga we use emotions to gain mastery over the emotions. Many people have wrong notions about bhakti. They think unless you believe in god or goddess you cannot be a bhakta. Unless you go to a temple you cannot be a bhakta. So when you look at Bhagavad Gita, the 12th chapter, this is not mentioned. It's a science as to how you gain mastery over the emotions. Just like Raja Yoga says, you gain mastery over the willpower, over the mind. And Karma Yoga says you gain mastery over your action. How to do action in a perfect way. Similarly, in Jnana Yoga, you use your intellect and you gain mastery over the intellect. In the same way, Bhakti Yoga says you have to gain mastery over the emotions. And what is the goal? The goal is same. Whether you talk the path of Jnana, or path of Karma, or the path of Raja Yoga, or the path of Bhakti. Everything leads to the same goal. What is that goal? Called moksha. Moksha means freedom. Absolute freedom. Freedom from what? Freedom from all our tensions and stresses. Freedom from all our diseases. Freedom from all our bondages. What are the bondages? Bondage of the mind. Slavery of the emotions. Bondage of the intellect. And the bondage of the body. Hey, you'll be able to overcome even the bondage of the body. What are the bondage of the body? You have to take food, you have to drink, and bound by the gravitation. All this can be overcome. Yes. So that is the most coveted goal of human existence. Our ancient spheres were very, very ambitious people. They are not be satisfied if they become a billionaire or a trillionaire. They are not satisfied if they become the richest person in the whole universe and they have all the wealth of the universe. They will not be satisfied. If they become the emperor of the whole universe, not enough. We want perfect happiness. Permanent happiness, infinite happiness. We want infinite knowledge. Knowledge of the whole universe. There should be no other knowledge which is to be known. That should be the knowledge. Kintam vignatam, sarvam vignatam bhavatiti. For the question asked by the student. And we want all the power. The power even to create the world. The most ambitious of the human existence. We are all very, very small. We'll be very happy, very small, satisfied with small things. Our ancient way, the yoga masters attained, wanted to have the highest. That's called moksha. That state is our real original state, called swarupa, as Patanjali says. So from that original state, we all have been created. The whole world has been created. Therefore, the goal of yoga is to go back home. We have forgotten our home. So yoga says, go back home. In the path of bhakti, you use emotions as tool to go back home. Unfortunately, the science of emotions is not available in our education system. We only deal with the intellect, essentially, to some extent mind, not the emotions at all. As a result, our students are all stuck with the emotional problems. Depression, excitement, and neuroticism, all types of mental challenges. Why? Because we have not been taught as to how we have to deal with emotions. When you encounter different demanding situations in life, we just get lost. I was in Australia, and everywhere the biggest problem in Australia is the depression. Young people, teenagers, they are all depressed. So the government was very worried. They said, okay, we have to solve this big challenge in our country. What is this? 35% of the people, teenagers, they should be bubbling with joy, energy, enthusiasm. They all become depressed. Shame on us, shame on us. So they called the biggest of the psychiatrists of Australia, the topmost expert from the Sydney University, they made him the director, gave the task. In next 10 years, you have to solve this problem of depression. Are you prepared? They'll give you enough money. You have a huge building they gave. And you have any number of people. You use any information technology. Anything you want. We'll give you $100 million to start up. You want more money? Don't worry, we'll give you. But target, from 35% you should come down to zero. If not zero, only 2-3% in 10 years. Okay? And the big inaugural program, the Prime Minister came, and the project was called Project Beyond Blue. This all happened 15 years back, 2001. And recently I was there. I talked to the director, it was all in Melbourne. And I asked, how is the situation? Have you been able to bring down? No, sir. It has gone up from 35%, it has gone up to 38%. Why? Because we don't know how to deal with the emotions. Modern science has not fathomed. It's here that yoga gives the solution. Yoga tells us that you must understand. What do you understand? Asuri Sampat and Daivi Sampat. What are your virtues? What are our vices? What are the good things that you are having? What are the bad things you have? Asuri Sampat and Daivi Sampat. Every one of us are made of these two. Some people have more asuri sampat, some people have more daivi sampat. What are those vices? They are called the enemies of man. Six enemies. Anger, greed, jealousy, hatred, infatuation, arrogance, kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mada, matsarya. Six enemies of man. They are called the asuri sampat. The vices. What are the good qualities? Magnanimity, service, sharing, be happy all the time, and magnanimity, and control over the senses, compassion and love, all the good qualities called the Daivi Sampat. Why do you call them as good? Why do you call them as bad? No. So Krishna is extremely scientific. He gives you the definition of good and definition of bad. Anything that takes you towards moksha, anything that makes you more and more happier day by day, any quality that helps you to get more and more knowledge, any qualities that help you to day by day reach greater and greater freedom, that's called good. Daivi Sampat Vimokshaya. Any quality that frees you from the bondage, any quality that makes you move towards the moksha is called as good quality. And the opposite is asuritam. Nibandhaya asurimata. That which makes you more and more stay. Increased challenges, problems, depressions, neuroticism, asthma, diabetes, hypertension, heart problem, epilepsy, migraine, irritable bowel syndrome, cancer. Those are the bad qualities. Virtues and the vices. In management system, we call it a SWOT analysis. What are your strengths? What are your weaknesses? When you analyze any organization, any system, you must understand what are your strengths, what are your weaknesses. And then what are the opportunities, what are the tools that are available. So Bhakti Yoga tells you first understand yourself. Then you have to decide. You want to continue as your slaves? You continue to suffer from various diseases, problems, challenges? Or you want to get free from that? Choice is yours. Having said all this in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says in the end to Arjuna, okay, I have to tell you all these things. Now it is left to you. Do whatever you want. You want to go up and reach the highest state of that moksha, or you want to go down, become worse than an animal and suffer and suffer? Choice is yours. We are all endowed with that wonderful freedom to go this way or to go this way. This is a human speciality. Therefore, Krishna says, Uddharet Atmana Atman, Na Atmanam Avasadayet. You have richly deserved this human creation. So don't waste this life. Use your life to grow continuously. This is what Yoga says. Rise from our normal level to become great human beings, super, divine, and reach moksha itself. This is what Yoga is. So Bhakti Yoga therefore tells, first start moving towards Daini Sampad. Lessen your Asuri Sampad and increase your Daini Sampad. So what are these Daini Sampad? How to do that? Very easy. Sharing, giving. Develop the habit of giving. Every day, at least two things you must give. Any two things you want. You have money, you have food, you have clothes, okay, give it. You don't have anything, doesn't matter. Krishna is very magnanimous. Patram, pushpam, phalam, toyam, yome bhaktya prayachati. Give a leaf, give a flower, give a fruit, or give a water, anything will do. So when you are coming, there are nice flowers that have fallen. Pick a few of them and give it to your friend. Or there is some leaves, take that, nicely clean it, and then give it to him. Cup of water. Somebody wanting some help, take them, move that. In your own ways, you develop the habit of giving. This is called the Prema Bhava. In Prema Bhava, you go on giving and giving and giving without expecting anything in return. In normal love, in normal friendship, always there is expectation of a return. You become good friends. How do you become friends normally? We have common likes or common dislikes. I like gulab jamun, you also like gulab jamun. We become gulab jamun friends. You like Carnatic music and she also like Carnatic music. They become good friends. Not only that, we also become friends on common dislikes. You also don't like him, I also don't like him, therefore we become good friends. Once I was traveling in train, and there was one person in the compartment went on criticizing Indira Gandhi. We are moving from Kanyakumari to Delhi, way back in 77. Then nobody was talking anything. There was one person who was passerby, and he heard that, immediately he came, he also sat, went on adding fuel to fire. He will tell one thing and he will tell another. Went on talking, 40 hours, they become such friends. Common dislikes. This is the normal way by which we become friends. This is the normal karmal law. But contained in that is always expectation of a return. Because you are my good friend, I will give you a nice gulab jamun party. But I expect you also give me a nice gulab jamun party. If you don't give me, Slowly our friendship breaks. Once more I will give pardon. Still you don't give, then our friendship breaks. Whereas in prema bhava, it is not there. No expectation of anything in return. You go on giving and giving and giving. This is what every mother does. Mother does for the child. This is called vatsalya bhava, prema bhava. Imagine in a society, all people want to give and give and give. It will become an ideal social order. Now what has happened? Everything we want to grab, grab, grab. Somehow we want to become rich and then we take everything. Selfish. So Krishna says the first step is to develop that prema bhava by giving. But it is very easily said than done. You forget. Now you hear me, okay, we do like this and nothing happens. So in the night you must write a diary. Did I do two good things today? What are things I did? You write down. And you will see a miraculous change in your life. You will become happier day by day, day by day. All the good qualities. So this is how you can transform yourself and transform the whole society. We can build ideal social orders. This is what we had done in our country. In Vijayanagar Empire and others which stood for centuries. This prema bhava was brought into everybody. One step in Bhakti Yoga can create an idea of social orders. But then Krishna also cautions, when you are giving, slowly ahankara may come. Oh, I am a great giver. Ego may shoot up. So be careful. He says, bhaktya prayachati. You go to the next level, from prema to bhakti. In bhakti, you must not allow it, you go to grow. Ego has to be subsided. You have to be diffused. Surrender is the key essence. What characterizes bhakti is surrender. Surrender, we always very difficult to give up our ego. Why? We think by giving up my ego, all my capacities will go away. Wrong, sir. So Vivekananda gave the secret. Surrender is expansion. By the process of surrender, you are going to grow in a very big way. And this is how all great people have become great by the process of surrender. If you understand the secret, it becomes very easy to surrender. To give up your ego becomes easy. To whom to surrender? You can choose God or Goddess if you believe in that. If you don't believe, choose a role model whom you revere the most. Maybe your husband, maybe your father, maybe your mother, maybe your wife, maybe your son, or maybe your scientist, maybe your professor, maybe your teacher. Choose your role model and you must tune. You must tune. Surrender is a process of tuning, just like a radio or TV. You go on tuning and you get particular. You tune your radio to BBC, all the information is going to come. In the same way, you tune your mind to that wonderful role model of a person, all his qualities slowly start coming. This is bhakti. So choose your Ishta Devata. What do you want to become? You want to become very brilliant, full of wisdom, Saraswati is your Aradhya Devata. You want to become very rich, Lakshmi is your Aradhya Devata. You want to have full of power, Hanuman. You want to have all the good qualities, Maharshi Rama. You want to be an embodiment of love, Christ. You want to have the best of all the things in the world, Krishna Bhagavan. Choose your own Ishta Devata. Search in your heart what you want to achieve in life. And through this, and go on doing the japa every day. Sit and go on praying, surrendering. You will find a miraculous change. This is Bhakti Yoga. And the day will come when you have the sakshatkara. Hanuman, go on doing that. Ram, mein Ram naam ho gaya uska. To usse kya hua? Ram ka sakshatkara ho gaya. Isko bolte hai sakshatkara. Bhakti ka vyasan hai sakshatkara. और उसी पर देखना शुरू किया. सब जगह में राम 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 राम. एवरीथिंग बिकम्स राम. दैट इज द वंडरफुल भक्ति दैट वी हैव टू. सो स्टार्ट बाय व्हाट? टू एक्ट्स ऑफ गिविंग एवरी डे एंड चूज योर इष्ट देवता. एवरी डे सिट एंड मेडिटेट, प्रे, गॉड प्लीज रेल मी टू द हायर हाइट्स. सरेंडर सरेंडर. And the day will come soon, you will get sakshatkara. Let's contemplate, sit straight with the eyes closed. Relax all parts of the body. Beautiful smile on the face. Check in your life, whether you are Asuri predominant or Daivi predominant. And make a resolve, from today I want to increase my Daivi Sampad, all good qualities, Dana, Daya, control over the senses, and love and compassion, all things, by simple act of giving two things in my life. And choose your Ishta Devata, Hanuman, Rama, Krishna, Lakshmi, Saraswati, Christ, anybody whom you consider as your role model, maybe your professor, maybe your teacher, maybe your brother, sister, anybody, choose. Go on repeating, sitting in prayer, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, fully surrender. Now at same time, every day in the morning, you worship Saraswati. Embodiment of all knowledge and wisdom. Then all that you want to do in the exam are going to come up. Vaidhi bhakti, vaidhi para bhakti, let us grow and grow and grow to the highest heights. Come to Namaskar Mudra. Om Asato Ma Sadgamaya Tamaso Ma Jyotirgamaya Mrityorma Amritandamaya. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah. Amen.